Hello, hello, everybody. I am currently connected to power right now, so the charger goes in the bottom of the phone, which means I have to hold up my phone with my arm this whole time. But anyway, today I wanted to do a quick live about the difference between a bookkeeper, an accountant, and a financial coach or consultant. And there actually are differences between coaching and consulting that I will hopefully talk to as well. So this is just really quick and informative, and I think it'll help you, especially if you are feeling somewhat frustrated with or overwhelmed or just totally confused, or maybe you have no idea with what's going on with the numbers in your business and you're wondering who to hire. So I'm going to speak to kind of the average and the most popular way that bookkeepers, accountants, and financial coaches work with their clients, although there are some amazing hybrids out there that do go above and beyond and offer services outside of the scope of what people would usually think they should or would offer. So if we break it down, let's start with a bookkeeper. A bookkeeper is someone who usually takes all of the money coming in and going out of your business, usually in your bank accounts, maybe also your credit cards and your payment processors, but they take them and they consolidate them into your books. And usually you might be using a bookkeeping software, or your bookkeeper might do it all via a spreadsheet, just depending on how they want to work with you. But they will reconcile your books for you. And this can be really helpful because your books will ultimately create your financial reports. So you've probably heard of, but may be like, and it might give you like heart palpitations when you hear of things like an income statement or profit and loss, or a balance sheet or a statement of cash flows. But those are things that your books ultimately create for you. And your bookkeeper will go and reconcile, you know, if money is coming in, is it coming in through an investment that you're making into your company, or is it coming from a sale of a product or a service? What does that look like? They'll determine what that is, and so that determines where it will flow into your reports. And then they will also categorize where money and how money is going out of your business. So is it going out as an owner's draw? Maybe you're taking money out to pay for bills or make an investment in your personal life. Or are you spending money through your business on business-related expenses? And then they can determine which chart of accounts those expenses fall under. So that's primarily what the bookkeeper's job is to consolidate your books and create reports so that you can look at those reports and make decisions, and then also create a journal entry or provide information to your accountant or your tax preparer so they can do your taxes. Now, a lot of accountants will have bookkeepers that work within their business, and you can hire the bookkeeper through them. Or some accountants will also do bookkeeping. It just depends on what kind of level you end up working with the person on and what sort of services they offer. So your accountant is someone who generally, for the most part, kind of in the way that a lot of online businesses work with accountants, is the accountant is someone who is doing your taxes. So they're most likely a tax accountant. Now, you can hire like an on-staff accountant for your business, and they would be doing more of maybe the book balancing, but also invoicing and making sure vendors are getting paid. And these are for businesses that, you know, might have much more difficulty, complexity involved in them. But for most online businesses, you don't necessarily need an accountant on staff. Most people are just looking to work with a tax accountant, or you could also work with like a registered tax preparer, someone who just understands taxes and can help you during tax time. So the accountant typically takes what you have in your books, or maybe you just hand them over a spreadsheet. I did that for many years because I would do my books on my own in my own little spreadsheet because I'm a nerd. But the accountant will take that information and then they will file your taxes for you. And usually an accountant will also tell you or give you tax estimates, quarterly tax estimates for the following year, or they can do it throughout the year to help you understand how much money you need to pay to the IRS or how much you can expect to pay. And then you can determine when and how you're going to pay those. So In some cases, an accountant will also be your bookkeeper, will provide you a bookkeeper, but it's not always the case. In a lot of cases, they're two separate entities, and either you are responsible for keeping your own books, or you would hire a bookkeeper to do that for you and then pass that information along to the accountant. Now, a financial coach. So financial coaches and consultants specifically help you with the cash flow in your business and help you understand your financial reports. So things like the profit and loss slash income statement, your balance sheet, maybe your statement of cash flows, whatever that looks like. But really, where a financial coach will play a role in your business is helping you understand what a good investment would be to make, how to price your products, how to project for, you know, future services or products that you want to provide, how to plan for the year. And by the way, an accountant might be able to and might be willing to help you with that, but generally if you're hiring a tax accountant, they're really only focused on working with you during tax time. But there are, of course, amazing service providers that will do kind of it all or that will do a mixture of all of this. But specifically, financial coaches will help you with the cash flow, will help you in some cases with projecting, will help you determine if an investment is a good one to make for your business. They can help you with analyze and track past investments and decide if it's a good investment to make for your future. And a lot of things based on the decision-making process of what's happening inside of your business. So coaches and consultants can be a little bit different. I would consider myself a coach and a consultant because as a coach, I work a lot with my clients on mindset as well as goal setting and planning. But as a consultant, I often advise them or guide them or provide them tips and tools and strategies to implement into their business because I've been there, done that, or I've worked with someone who has been there, done that, and I can help them see, okay, this is a really good place for me to go. And I'll also create a lot of tools for them as well. So if there's a great spreadsheet that works really well for my previous clients, but maybe this new client needs it tweaked a little bit based on their business and their service or their products, then I can always tweak it from there. But a financial coach and consultant will often help you review what's happened in the past and make decisions for the future. And I think that's the best way to think about it. And then from a coaching perspective, they can also help you with goal setting and planning. And even if they are someone who is certified or just has experience with mindset work, they can help you on the mindset level as well, which I obviously think is very important. It's often the centerpiece or the foundation of our ability to achieve our goals and have financial success. So that's the difference. And I personally know a lot of people who do all three, but they tend to be a little bit limited in how many people they can take on because if they're doing their bookkeeping and the tax preparation and the coaching, it can become a lot. But I think it's awesome if there is someone out there. If you're looking for something specific, hopefully this helps you identify what sort of help you're looking for and who would be able to provide that guidance and assistance for you. And if you guys are interested in what it looks like to work with me, then you can sign up for a very low ball offer. I'm doing the Payday Party Workshop, which is kind of a fun crash course of what it's like to work with me on a more longer term private coaching level. And it's a week-long workshop. It's $67, so super low barrier to entry. And we will meet four times for sure, but I already know of at least one bonus class we're also going to do. But over the course of four classes, the kind of main agenda that we're covering is both the money mindset, uncovering money blocks, uncovering limiting beliefs, and then identifying your purpose-driven revenue goals on a need, want, and dream basis. I provide you with my financial dashboard, a piece of the dashboard I provide to my private clients that will help you set these goals for yourself in a very organized fashion. And then I teach you a system so that you can start becoming the CFO of your business and you can implement the system super easily and actually start paying yourself and be profitable the moment you implement this system. So it's really, really cool once you learn the system and you get it implemented and it all makes sense for most of the business owners. I would say all of the business owners that actually sign up and go through the workshop. And then in addition to that, we focus in the fourth class on more modalities and understanding and learning and practicing and using certain modalities that will get you a big shift back on the money mindset level. So we start with money mindset and we end with money mindset. And in the middle, we shove those two very practical, tangible goal setting and system implementation classes that will make everything kind of tie together for you. So if you're interested, go to wonderwealthy.com/party. Like I said, it's a really good way to get exposure and experience in working with me and see what it's like to work with a financial coach within your business, and also how I marry the two practical, more masculine numbers, strategy, systems implementation with the more feminine mindset work and releasing limiting beliefs from the subconscious mind and trusting and going into your intuition. So wonderwealthy.com/party. I would love to see you there. And if you guys have any questions, feel free to reach out. You can find me on email at tess@wonderwealthy.com or hit me up in the messages of Facebook or Instagram. All right, see you later.